You're the robot, Burning Man.
Technology can be a bicycle for the mind. A tool to help humanity become the best it can be, and frankly, that sounds lovely. But somewhere along the line, we seem to underestimate the ease at which machines could switch on and off our reptile brain. That what we built could actually manipulate our minds, desires, and society, the fabric of this world we've made. That these little screens could overtake the life that they're supposedly capturing. We shouldn't throw it all away. There's so much value that they bring. Technology is human ingenuity. It's background. But somewhere along the way, we let these systems rearrange the way we value everything. This place was founded on values. But like so much of society, pointing technology at these is more complicated than it seems. If we create an algorithm that gets the perfect gift for everybody, that at first sounds amazing, but would miss the point completely. It would lose all the magic that comes from people gifting, the thoughtfulness, the serendipity, and the effort that we put in. If robots cleaned the plyo, we wouldn't have to pick up anything, but we'd miss the lived experience of caring for the space we're in. We'd miss the lesson, the intention, the reason for this value's creation. Sometimes the answer isn't the answer. Sometimes questions are the answer, and sometimes getting lost is the only way to find our way. What's the point of all this innovation if we sacrifice the things that make life worth living? If we sacrifice meaning in pursuit of efficiency? If we isolate ourselves in search of connectedness? If we lose our why in pursuit of success? If we become mindless in our pursuit of progress? Life happens fast, and it's over in an instant. Technology happens faster, and if we don't insist on designing it to value our humanity,
then we just might lose.
How can we use technology thoughtfully? How can we start minimally and carefully, checking in along the way on what we're losing as we're gaining? This space has always been a playground on which to innovate, and this will always be the case. But as we move into the future and as we create the next wave of existence, how can we do so with our radical humanity?
It took that long for those MFers to acknowledge our work. We've been mobbing the playa, stealing girlfriends, stealing boyfriends, stealing coolers. All right, baby. You coming back to camp? You want to crack a beer with us?